Hello, this is Noreen Crone Findlay. I'm the author of The Woven Bag, 30 plus projects from small looms. You can order this from any online bookseller or from your local bookseller. Now, you can find lots of my wonderful books and things at cronefindlay.com, and I blog at toddytalkscrafts.com. Of course, this video is copyright, so no, you can't just borrow it. Anyhow, today I'm going to show you how I weave with yarn on the potholder loom. Now, when you're working with yarn on the potholder loom, if you're using sport weight yarn, you'll want to use two strands held together. Usually, I mean, if you want a really open, lacy one, you'd use one. If you're using bulky yarns, use just one strand. If you're using really fine yarns, use multiple strands, 3, 4, 5, 6. You start by tying the yarn to the lower right-hand corner of your loom. Then you're going to very loosely, whenever you're weaving, when you're warping your potholder loom, your yarn is put onto the loom very loosely. The reason for that is that there's a lot of take-up in the weaving. That means that the yarns going under and over each other makes it get gradually tighter. So if it's too tight at the get-go, it's going to be miserable when you're finished. Now what you're going to do is you're going to go back and forth right across the loom and going from the lower edge to the upper edge until you have the entire loom covered with yarn. Then the next step is you're going to take your loom, and you're going to use either a chopstick or a knitting needle, and you're going to use this as a shed stick. So weave over four, because I worked with two strands of yarn. I'm going over, see, there's four strands. Go over four, under four, all the way across. That, you can see, that opens a space between the alternating sets of yarn, of warp strands. Now, you're going to work continuously. This means that, oops, I just need to flip this yarn around here. This means that the yarn that was your warping yarn is going to now turn into your weft yarn. You're going to, at the lower corner here, you're going to be going up to the next peg. So we're going to weave our first row, and I always use a weaving hook. Now, I carved this one from a chopstick, but you can carve them from dowels, or if you are lucky enough to find a metal Afghan hook, then great, grab it, because they're terrific. I don't like the wire hooks very much that come with the looms. Okay, so we're going to start by going under four, over four, under four, over, under, all the way across. Now the actual weaving is done with the hook. So there we go. We're going to take that hook through the first set of that first space between the first two hooks. Now, see what I've done? I've folded a loop of yarn and put that loop over the hook. By folding a loop of yarn, you're going to create a whole lot less tension on the yarn, and it's much better for the yarn. It doesn't stress it, and it doesn't split and do all kinds of nasty things. Now, you can see I'm just scooting my hook along the chopstick and then down to the next space. Make my loop of yarn, put it on the hook, ease it through, and next hook over. Pardon me, next peg over, push it down, and look, we've woven two rows quick like a bunny. Now, here's a square that I have woven. I've just repeated that two sets of rows all the way to the top. Now, I'm going to do the edging. First of all, I'm going to untie the where I tied on at the lower edge. I've also snipped yarn off the ball and left those strands just loose. I like to have enough yarn that I can sew the squares together, because they're actually modules for the pieces that you're working on. Now, I'm going to take the first Okay, I'm starting at the first corner, lower right-hand corner. I'm going to lift off the first set of loops, then the second set of loops, and pull the second through the first, lift off the third, take it through the second, and so on, all the way up the right-hand side of the loom. And I'm going to go up the right-hand side of the loom and continuing to chain it off, which gives, you know, this gives a really nice finish. I'm going to go up, I'm going to go across, and then if I wanted, I could lift the rest of the loops off because they are actually captured. They're not going to go and unweave themselves. The right-hand side and the top ones will. So don't take it off until you have chained all the way across. Now, sometimes people find that the lower left-hand corner seems weird to them. See, here I have chained up the first side, across the top, and down the second side. I'm going to turn the loom now, and I'm going to just finish chaining off the left-hand side. Now, I'm going to lift those loops off, take them through, and because of the way you warp the loom and start to use the continuous weft, you're going to end up with one really big loop at that lower, see, it's the lower left-hand corner. So what we're going to do is go through once and then pick up again and twice, and then we can lift it off the loom and finish by chaining off the lower edge to finish our square. Now, once we work all the way across to the starting corner, then you will seal the fate of the square by, you'll finish it off, by taking the starting strands through that loop. And you know, I also find this loop is kind of loose if I don't take it one more pass up the right-hand side. And then I take the starting strands through, pull it through, and voila! I'm going to turn it so that it is aligned the way the square was aligned on the loom. And there we have it, a beautifully woven square from the potholder loom. And so come back to my YouTube channel for more wonderful videos. And also don't forget to go to kronfindlay.com and toddytalkscrafts.com. That's my blog. Talk to you soon. Bye for now and thanks.